Well, it took an extra day to get out, but we're loading up. A lot of excitement. We're gonna need to take two.
We're
gonna need to take two planes.
Do you want any of these in the other plane, or is this?
Probably take that other little cub there.
Take my fat ass off of that. Yeah.
This is the cub, right?
Oh yeah, that's the super cub there.
This is the bigger one, I think.
It is. Yeah, this is called the 206.
Okay.
It's called the super cub.
All right, we've got two planes going up today. This one is the smaller version, the Super Cub. Both float planes, larger version. The rest of the group is going to be going on this one. What's this one called?
The 212. 205. 206. 206. We got two pilot.
Let's rock and roll.
All right.
Right. Where's the ejector seat button?
There goes Erica. We're going to catch up with her. She's in the Super Cub. We're going to catch up with her and fly past her in the big one here. All right, Joe's ready. So's Lucas. very much. Thanks for a great flight.
Up from Paradise Lake. Got Joey who just dropped us off safely. It's a Tuesday, beautiful morning, and he's about to give us a little show.
Whoa,
wow, he got right up. That wind picked him right up off the water.
He's gonna be wrapping around.
Here he goes.
Well, boys, I think we're alone now.
Oh, look at that. That's cool.
Oh, jeez. I hope he gets higher. That is
Oh, my God.
He's coming right for us.
Wave. Wow! Yeah, I think I left a little poopy in my pants. Little breezy and misty. There's our boat. Let's take a tour of the Upper Paradise Cabin. Nice deck since Erica and I were here last. Hello.
Welcome.
Hello.
Welcome, welcome to Upper Paradise Lake Cabin.
Oh, it's nice. It's like I remember it.
And
nice
recently and renovated, in fact.
It has been renovated.
Just
point out the renovations.
Renovated.
Yeah, the bunks are new.
The fire was rolling before we got in here.
No, we got new flooring. Look at that. We got a new table. That old bench and table are new. Those counters are new. The stove, I don't know if that's new or not. Yeah, the piping, you can see it. The piping's all new. Yeah, this is great. They left a bunch of wood for us, the people ahead of us, so Lucas is going to get a little dizzy blowing up mattresses. We're blowing up our mattresses. Getting ready to go outside and try the wind and rain and go hike a little bit, huh?
Explore a little.
Explore a little. All right. We're home.
I don't know if we can make it, Bill.
I made it. You can make it.
I don't know if we can make it.
We're on the Snow River behind the cabin. We're exploring, yeah. This is kind of interesting. We tried to bushwhack through this stuff. It is so thick in there. We found a little game trail. Now we're gonna go up the Snow River. This river feeds the Kenai. This is the Snow River, feeds the Kenai. We're gonna go explore a little bit, see how far we can get up on these gravel bars.
You'll notice that they're taking my boots all the way back to Erica so that she can cross and I'm less stranded. That's all right. I think they still love me. You may be asking, why is Lucas barefoot? The answer lies across the small stream where they're giving my boots to Erica come back to cross. Linking arms.
Down the Snow River, and we found some fresh water, a little fresh water stream. It just happens to be that right next to it, in the gravelly sand, there's three different set of tracks here. So for you guys at home, pop quiz, this one in the middle, you know what that is? Moose!
That's a moose!
That's a moose!
It's a big moose.
How about this one over here?
It's a doggy.
Well, bigger than a doggy.
It's a wolf. Big wolf.
A wolf. Those are wolf tracks. And then finally, I don't even know where they are, Dad.
There they are.
Here.
Right in front.
Yeah, those are black bear.
Those are black bear. Look, there's some good ones up there.
There's
look at how pronounced they are up here.
Look at those. Can't
bear.
That's black bear. Very cool.
Where's the human boot?
This is fresh water. We're walking along a glacier stream, and this is fresh water running off that mountainside. So they're probably coming down here to drink. Very cool. Pretty spectacular out here.
It looks like a smaller bear.
Yeah.
Oh, it's called a wolf. Oh,
it looks more like a bear.
Bear cub. We just did a switch up. We had a substitution of boots from Erica to Lucas to get him across because he can't jump that. Up there we have a beautiful, beautiful mountainside. Kind of reminds me of my girlfriend's legs as.
What?
Cut!
Cut!
Cut it!
That was about to take the biggest spill of his life. Kind of looks like Yoda from the back, doesn't it?
It's a shark!
Joe's grayling!
Woo! Actually, that's a good one.
That's a nice one. That's a dinner size one. That's a nice one. Absolutely. We'd eat him tomorrow.
All right. We're on day two of our trip. Woke up at like 11:30 a.m.
No, we did not.
It was a little earlier than that, but Joe fell asleep on his bunk and he woke up down here. Not quite sure how that happened, but I know that during the course of the night, he dropped a water bottle directly on Grandpa's head.
Ouch! What the hell's going on with you? Are you all right?
You okay?
Are you okay?
We're all packing up to go out. We're going to go fishing at the south end of the lake, which none of us have ever visited. So we're going to paddle all the way down there in the rowboat and then do some fishing, catch tonight's dinner.
Who's captain of the rowboat?
That would be me.
All right. Let's go take a peek at the weather. It had blue sky for a while, but it's socked in again. But who cares? We're going.
This one seems kind of strong.
Pull him in. Maybe that's where they're hiding. Maybe they're hiding down in that water, fast water more. No, it's a good one. Where'd he go? I'll get him.
Whoa! Lucas, help.
Go help your cousin.
That's not happening. That's not.
He's gonna. He's in the quicksand. Oh my God, look at that. Can you get out?
That should be fine.
Oh. Wow.
I'm the mud man.
You were just gonna let him sink, weren't you?
Well, we'd be Tweedledum and Tweedledee stuck in the mud. What's that?
Yeah.
What do you think it was?
It was a ripple in the water.
And that's where we're going. This is an aborted attempt. This is an aborted attempt to get through this thicket, to get up that hillside.
It's like a full body workout, man.
It's like aborted attempt number two. We'll see where we go from here.
Climbing up some pretty thick brush. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Guess I'm next.
Use your knees. There you go.
Oh, this is the better part?
Join us.
Woo!
Well, Joe, we survived the alders.
I have a feeling there's going to be more.
More coming.
There's no way we're all the way done.
That's what we just bushwhacked through. Holy buckets. But we're in a little bit of a clearing here. There's the lake. Beautiful scenery. Way down there is our little cabin.
Be careful, Lucas.
Can you put your arms up? Okay, you can put them on your hips, okay.
Got it.
Little nap.
Everybody hates the Wolverines, right, Bill?
Mmm. A challenging climb.
Thank you.
get here, we have battled the grasslands, the alders, the small shrubs, the big shrubs, the scree, the snow, the waterfalls. How many times have we crossed the water?
Oh, God.
Oh, my gosh. Steep slopes, slippery moss. But now here we are in the beautiful tundra. It's easy walking, nice and flat, no bugs. This is nice.
I like this. Sunny day. We earned this. Quite a view up here. We are at altitude. There it is, Wolverine Glacier. Joe went to check out the edge to look down on Wolverine Glacier. We're going to take a break and relax a little bit for our long haul back. There's another glacier across the valley. We don't know the name of that one, but it sure is pretty up here. But we are bushed, tired, ready to head back. Long way.
How does he still have so much energy?
I don't know. Trying to find our way home down that cliff. What do you think, Lucas? Having fun?
Absolutely, I'm not.
Ready to be ended, huh?
I'm all right.
Me too. We're on a steep slope. Looking to go back down in there and fight the alders to go back through that meadow and find our boat, go back to the cabin. The cabin is way over there. We've had a hell of an adventure, and we ain't done yet. Trying to get a little energy on the hillside. Long way to go down. Up.
We're aboard the Paradox, heading out to a brand new spot. At the helm, we have Joe Mack.
Ahoy, matey.
And Captain, First Mate, Grandpa. We got Arno in the house. Lucas.
Glad we got Lucas.
What are we going out for today, Dad?
We're gonna try a new spot for halibut. A couple of guys told me that I saw them pulling four big pig halibut off their boat. Nothing under 35 pounds. So we're gonna try a new spot and see what we can do. So we're gonna throw the dice.
All right, Lucas.
He's got a big one on.
Says he's got a big one on.
I'm putting it between my legs.
He's here he goes. Are we seeing it yet?
Oh, look at that fight.
Oh, I can see something down there. Woo! I can see something. Here it comes.
That's a nice fish. Holy fuck.
You ready?
Oh my gosh, that's a big one. I think we need to harpoon this guy. Wow.
Harp.
Oh yeah.
Harpooned.
All aboard. All aboard the harpoon.
Nice job, Lucas.
Huge.
Emily is on to one. It is pulling that line out. Holy buckets, look at this thing. She's fighting this thing for a while. We'll see what we got. Yep, we're into some nice fish. Carol's next.
Holy crap.
Yeah, buddy!
We might have to shoot and reload.
Oh my gosh!
Holy
cow!
This is insane.
He's gonna run, but we're gonna have to get him up so I can get a harpoon in him. But I gotta get him up closer to the surface to get a harpoon in him.
Watch that gun.
He might run. Didn't get it in. He's running. Let him run. Angle to shove this through it. I'm in. Let him take it.
Out of the boat.
Okay. You got the calf? Okay. No, hold on. I'm going to get this other one in. Don't try to pull him up there.
Girl, hop in again.
Emily.
Yeah!
You just caught the monster of the day. What are you going to do now?
Eat it.
Holy buckets. Man, that was a challenge getting that thing in.
Oh, way to go, team.
It was a team effort. Thank God I brought the gun.
Oh, man.
All right, now we got to figure out what to do with it.
An anchor,
I hope so.
Fish, a gun.
An anchor, a fish, a gun. And fish.
Yeah, we had to fight the anchor. Oh, my God, that's big.
Hey!
All right, Emily, lift him into the tub.
Kenai Peninsula.
On a rainy day.
On a rainy day.
Sharpening knives.
Shooting guns and sharpening knives.
Sharpening knives. Because it's too rainy.
Because it's manly.
Thank you.